Hi everyone, welcome back to the new video of Current Affairs YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the important Current Affairs questions and answers of the day. 12 July 2021 for all competitive examinations. Okay, you have two questions at the end of this video. So watch the video till then and please comment your answer in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. Okay, let's start the section. First question. Who has won the 2021 Scripps National Spelling Bee? Okay, the answer for the question is option C. Saila Avangarde. Okay, let's see about this. Saila Avangarde, a 14-year-old basketball prodigy, has won the 2021 Scripps National Spelling Bee, becoming the first African-American contestant to win in 93rd edition of the prestigious competition. Okay, the Indian-Americans, who have been dominating the National Spelling Bee for years, had to be satisfied with the second and third position. And Avangarde correctly spelled Muraya, a genus of tropical Asiatic Australian trees having pinned leaves and flowers, to win the competition and $50,000 prize money. A basketball prodigy, Avangarde holds three Guinness World Records for ability to dribble multiple basketballs at a time. Okay, the National Bee is a high-profile, high-pressure endurance test. As much as net spelling match, and spellers spend months to prepare for it. Okay, this question you have to note on that. The 2021 Scripps National Spelling Award has been awarded for Saila Avangarde. Okay, that's the answer. Okay, let's see next question. Who has been selected as the first ever Indian juror for the upcoming Tokyo Olympics Games? Okay, the answer for the question is option B, Pawan Singh. Okay, let's see about this. Pawan Singh, the Joint Secretary General of the National Rifle Association of India, that is NRAI, has been selected as the first ever Indian juror for the upcoming Tokyo Olympics Games. And he is the founder director of the Gun for Glory Shooting Academy in Balewadi in Pune. A total of 26 jury members will officiate the Olympics, of which 6 will be from Japan and the rest from other countries. Okay. Pawan Singh was the competition manager of the recent International Shooting Sports Federation World Cup in New Delhi, and his work was appreciated by the ISSF. And he has also worked as a result timing score jury in different World Cups. Okay, in this question, you have not done that. Pawan Singh has been selected as the first ever Indian juror for the upcoming Tokyo Olympics Games. Okay, that's the answer for the question. I think it's understood. Okay. Before watching this full video, if you like this video, please click on the like button. Okay, this video like aim is only 50. And if you are not a subscriber of this channel, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel Current Affairs. And also enable the bell icon for getting new notifications in our YouTube channel. Okay, let's see next question. Which state will conduct Ridhu Bharosa Chaitanya Yatra from July 9 to July 23, 2021? Okay, the answer for the question is option D, Andhra Pradesh. Okay, let's see about the 2021 Ridhu Bharosa Chaitanya Yatra. The Andhra Pradesh government will conduct Ridhu Bharosa Chaitanya Yatra from July 9 to July 23, 2021. It will create awareness among farmers on agriculture related aspects like continuous monitoring of agriculture prices and procurement, e-cropping and many more. Okay, the collectives were instructed by the Chief Minister to conduct mandate inspection to ensure that the deficiencies are rectified. Okay, that's the answer for the question. Okay, let's see some points about Andhra Pradesh. Okay, we can see here the location of Andhra Pradesh state here. Okay, the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh is Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, and the Governor of Andhra Pradesh, Vishwabhushan Harichandan. And the number of districts in the state of Andhra Pradesh is 13. Okay, that's the answer for the question, and also about Andhra Pradesh. Okay, I think it's understood. Okay, let's see next question. When is the National Fish Farmers Day celebrated every year? Okay, the answer for the question is option E, 10 July. Okay, let's see about the National Fish Farmers Day. The National Fish Farmers Day is celebrated every year on 10 July by the Department of Fisheries, Ministries of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying in association with National Fisheries Development Board. Okay, day is commemorated annually in remembrance of scientists Dr. K.S. Ali Kunhi and Dr. S.L. Chowdhury, who had invented induced breeding technology of Indian major carbs on 10 July 1957. Okay, this day is made to honor the fish farmers, aquapreneurs, fisher folks, stakeholders and whoever else is associated in the fishery for their contribution in the fishery. Okay, in this question you have to note on that. The National Fish Farmers Day is celebrated every year on 10 July. Okay, let's see the next question. The Finance Ministry has been expanded with the addition of Department of Public Enterprises, And it was set up as a Bureau of Public Enterprises in which year? Okay, the answer for the question is option B, 1965. Okay, let's see about the Department of Public Enterprises. The Finance Ministry has been expanded with the addition of the Department of Public Enterprises. Policy formulation for all central public sector units. Okay, as per the department website, it was set up as the Bureau of Public Enterprises in the year 1965 in the Ministry of Finance. Till now, it was part of the Ministry of Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises. Okay, in this question, you have to know that the Finance Ministry has been expanded with the addition of the Department of Public Enterprises, and it was set up as the Bureau of Public Enterprises in the year 1965. Okay, that's answer. Okay, let's see the next question. Mumbai Metro Authorities, along with which of the following, has launched a One Mumbai Metro Card? Okay, the answer for the question is option D, both A and B, that is Axis Bank and MasterCard. Okay, let's see about the One Mumbai Metro Card. Mumbai Metro, along with the MasterCard and Axis Bank, announced the launch of One Mumbai Metro Card to ensure contactless and cashless travel for Mumbai cards. The prepaid open loop contactless card can be used as part of the daily transit journey with just a tap. Okay, the card offers silent features such as contactless simplicity of use and top up speed and convenience for one's metro fare, as well as other daily spends such as grocery, restaurant and shopping. And the One Mumbai Metro Card can be bought from Mumbai Metro Station counters. Okay, that's about the One Mumbai Metro Card. Okay, I think it's understood. Okay, let's see next question. Which bank has signed an MOU with the Indian Army to offer a defense service salary package under its Power Salute initiative? Okay, the answer for the question is option C, Axis Bank. Okay, let's see about this initiative. The country's third largest private lender, Axis Bank, signed an MOU with the Indian Army offering a defense service salary package under its Power Salute initiative. According to the bank, it will offer personal accidental cover of up to 56 lakh rupees to all army personnel, addition up to 8 lakh education grant, total permanent disability cover benefit up to 46 lakh, permanent partial disability cover of up to 46 lakh rupees, air accident cover of 1 crore rupees, and free additional debit card for a family member. Okay, the benefits of this MOU will cover both serving defense personnel as well as defense pensioners. At present, the bank also offers unlimited free payable at birth checkbooks and unlimited free demand drafts and pay orders. Okay, in this question, you have not known about the MOU between the Indian Army and the Axis Bank. Okay, that's answer. Okay, let's see about Axis Bank. The Axis Bank Limited is an Indian banking and financial service company headquartered in Mumbai in Maharashtra state. Okay, the CEO of Axis Bank is Amitabh Chaudhary, and the Axis Bank was founded on 3rd December 1993. Okay, that's about Axis Bank. Okay, I think it's understood. If you have any doubts related to any question and its answer, please comment down in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. Okay, let's see next question. Who has been appointed as the Civil Aviation Minister? Okay, the answer for the question is option A, Jyotiraditya Scindia. Okay, let's see about this. Jyotiraditya Scindia has been appointed as the Union Civil Aviation Minister, replacing Hardeep Singh Puri, who will now head the Petroleum Ministry while also keeping the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Scindia, who joined the Bharatiya Janata Party, that is BJP, from the Indian National Congress, that is INC, during March 2020, is the son of late INC politician Madhav Rao Scindia, who too held the civil aviation portfolio under P.V. Narasimha Rao-led central government between 1991 and 1993. Okay, in this question, you have noted that Jyotiraditya Scindia has been appointed as a Union Civil Aviation Minister. Okay, that's it. So, okay, let's see next question. Which country has declared a state of emergency after the assassination of its president Jovenel Moïse? Okay, the answer for the question is option B, Haiti. Okay, let's see about this. Haiti has declared a state of emergency after the assassination of its president Jovenel Moïse, who was shot at and his wife injured in an attack on their home in the nation's capital, Port-au-Prince. Okay, Mr. Moïse had led the Caribbean country, one of the poorest nations in the world, since 2017, but had faced widespread protest demanding his resignation. Okay, that's the answer. Okay, let's see some points about Haiti. Okay, we can see here the location map of Haiti here. Haiti is a Caribbean country that shares the island of Hispaniola with the Dominican Republic to the east. Okay, the capital of Haiti is Port-au-Prince. We can hear the capital of Haiti here. Okay, the currency of Haiti, Haitian gold. Okay, in this question, you have to note on that. Haiti declares emergency following assassination of its president, Jovenel Moïse. And also note on the points about Haiti. Okay, that's the answer. Okay, let's see the next question. Keshav Dutt passed away recently. And here the question is, he was related to which of the following sports? Okay, the answer for the question is option A, hockey. Okay, let's see about Keshav Dutt. One of India's finest hockey players, a double Olympic gold medalist, Keshav Dutt passed away. He was part of India's historic feat at the 1948 Olympic, where they beat home team Britain for 4-0 at the Wembley Stadium in London to win the first gold post in. Before the 1948 Olympics, Dutt had toured East Africa under the leadership of hockey wizard Major Dhyanchand in 1947, and he was conferred with the Mohan Bagan Ratna Award in 2019, becoming the first non-footballer recipient of the honor. Okay, in this question, you have to know about Keshav Dutt, okay, who has passed away recently. Okay, that's the answer for the question. I think it's understood. Okay, let's see the answers for the questions of last kind of his question answer video of 11 July 2021. Okay, let's see the answer for the first question. Parshottam Rupala has been appointed as the Union Cabinet Minister in which ministry? Okay, the answer for the question is option D, Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Okay, let's see about this. Senior BJP leader Parshottam Rupala was promoted as the cabinet minister in the Modi government's major cabinet reshuffle and given the charge of the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Rupala, who comes from the influential Kadwa Patidar or Patil community in Gujarat, will be in charge of the ministry formed recently in 2019 in order to promote elite farm activities for enhancing farmers' income. And earlier, Rupala was holding charge as the Minister of State for Agriculture in the Union Cabinet. And he will replace his cabinet colleague Giriraj Singh, who has been shifted to the Ministry of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. Okay, in this question, you have to note that Parshottam Rupala gets Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Okay, that's the answer for the first question. I think it's understood. Okay, let's see the answer for the second question. Amazon India has launched its first digital Kendra in which city? Okay, the answer for the question is option A, Surat. Okay, let's see about this. Amazon India launched its first digital Kendra in Gujarat, Surat, under its initiative to digitize micro, small and medium enterprises. Okay, the center was inaugurated by the state chief minister Vijay Rupani, who has expressed confidence that the initiative would prove beneficial for around 41,000 MSMEs operating in Surat city. Okay, in this question, you have to note that Surat gets Amazon's first digital Kendra in India. Okay, that's the answer for the second question. I think it's understood. Okay, let's see today's questions for you. Okay, daily we are giving two questions that you can answer. And please comment your answer in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. Okay, let's see the first question for you. Who has been appointed as a new health minister as well as Minister for Chemical and Fertilizers? Okay, the options for him, option A, Nitin Gadkari, option B, Hardeep Singh Puri, option C, Mansukh Mandaviya, and option D, Anurag Singh Thakur. Okay, I will repeat the first question for one more time. Who has been appointed as the new health minister as well as Minister for Chemicals and Fertilizers? Okay, please comment your answer in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. Okay, let's see the second question for you. Stephen Lofven has been re-elected as the Prime Minister of which country? Okay, the options for you. Option A, Poland. Option B, Sweden. Option C, Denmark. And option D, Portugal. Okay, I'll repeat the second question. Stephen Lofven has been re-elected as the Prime Minister of which country? Okay, please comment your answer in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. Okay, in this video, we have discussed about the important kind of questions and answers of the day. 12 July 2021 for all competitive examinations. Okay, I think it's understood about the section. If you have any doubts related to any question and its answer, please comment down in the comment section given below. We will discuss that. And you can download the PDF file of this section in our Telegram group and you can also join our Telegram group for more study materials. Okay, I will keep the link in the description given below. You can check that and download the PDF. And if you're not a subscriber of this channel, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe our channel Current Affairs and also number the bell icon for getting new notifications in our YouTube channel. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Keep supporting us and see you tomorrow with a new video on Current Affairs and other study topics. Thank you. Bye-bye.